What's up, fifth graders? Hey, here we go. It's time for us to jump into just, I wanted to spend today talking about some of the questions that we missed from our math test. These are some questions that are like the ones, I think number one is still the same as the one on the math test, but the other ones I've just changed a little bit in case there's a couple of my friends out there that haven't taken the math test yet. I don't want to give you all the answers, so I've changed it up a little bit. All right, so let's check it out. Let's jump in. Let's look at number one. Number one, you had to put these in order from least to greatest. Now, an easy thing to do, well, for the most part, is to turn them into decimal numbers so we can figure it out. So I know 3/4 is equal to 0.75. So right off the bat, I can take 1 3/4 and know that that is 1.75. Now, I know I've got 1.65, 1.75. Now I just gotta try to figure out what that 7, that 9 over 7 would be. And if we made it a mixed number, like we have 1 3/4, it's gonna be 1 2/7. Now, 2 over 7, let's see, is that equal to half? What would half of 7 be, right? That would be 3.5. So obviously, that's less than a half. So this one right here is gonna be less than 1.5. So obviously, right off the bat, I can look and tell that that's gonna be my smallest fraction or smallest number to start with. So let's go 9/7. All right, and now I've got 1.65 and 1 3/4 or 1.75. Obviously, 1.65 is smaller because we look in the tenth place, right? That's a 6, that's a 7. So 1.65 and then 1 3/4. I think about 5 or 10 of you guys missed that one when I had checked on Friday. So, hey, that's one of those ones, you know, takes a little bit of time, takes a little bit of effort, but I know you guys can do it. Now, this problem said 15 pennies in a roll of 50 pennies. I went ahead and said 10 just to switch it up. But same thing, guys. All we're doing is finding a percentage. So if we wrote that fraction 15 over 50 or 10 over 50 in my example right here, now, what do we got to do to make that percentage? Oh, there goes my Corvette clock. That's what mine sounds like. All right, so 10 over 50, right? What do we got to do? Angelina, help me out here. What am I going to do to make this into a percentage? Remember, a percentage is just any number over 100. So we got to make this equal to a number over 100. So 50 times what gives me 100, Angelina? Exactly, 2. So we multiply the top times 2. That gives us 20 over 100. There's our percent. Now this is a little different than the one on the test because the test was 15. So if you would have done the same thing with 15, that would have given you the right percentage. A couple people gave me 10%. I don't even know how that's possible because we have 15 out of 50 of those pennies that were within the right date range or whatever it was. So 30, awesome. But a couple people put, I can't remember if it was 20, can't remember, or 15%. So you just went with the fact it was 15 over 50 equals 15%. We just missed this step right here that would have got it to the correct answer. Now check it out. I had at least 7 or 8 people miss this one right here. Now, just because this one's got 3 digits in it does not mean that it's smaller than this guy right here. Now, I flipped these up a little bit on you guys versus the one on the test just to mess with your brain a little bit. But if that's the case, hey, put a 0 on this. If I add a 0 on the right-hand side of this, does it change the value? No, it doesn't. But now we've got 3 digits, and now we can really look at it. This one would be 25 thousandths. This one's 250 thousandths. Now, obviously, which one's bigger? Right? All right, another way to check, look at the number closest to the decimal. 2's bigger than 0, done, that's it. No one should have missed that problem. Y'all not watching my videos, y'all. All right, A was a little tricky. A was a little tricky, but not really if you're paying attention to what it's saying in the problem. Now, number 8 in the problem, it said, what was the perimeter of that square? So we know each side is 10. Sweet, 10, 10, 10, 10. That equals 40, right? Now, was I talking about area? Was it talking anything about area? Because I know what it said on the test. It had 40 inches, and then it had 40 square inches, and then it had some crazy number. Now, I got a good 10 or so of you guys that went with the square inches, but we're not talking about area. We are only talking about the distance around the outside. Remember, if an area, we're talking about the inside, area is going to be squared on the inside. So that was wrong. We're not talking about that. Our correct answer would have been that 40 inches, because it's just talking about our distance around the outside of that shape. Now that got some of you guys. So hey, we only have one more test next week. We got one more math test. Uno más, solamente uno. Now, we also have a reteaching worksheet, I think, on Wednesday. So that's one, you know, maybe we're gonna take that for a quiz. So you might wanna make sure you're doing those online. I had a good like handful, like 5 to 10 of you guys, at least in my class, I'm not sure about Mrs. Phillips' class, that hasn't done the reteaching masters yet. I'm not sure if you did the hard copy, but in the videos, I told you guys, you need to be doing those in the Google Classroom. I've made those assignments. They're in there. You go in there, you click on them. You click on what the correct answer is for each problem, and then you submit that to your teacher, either me or Mrs. Phillips. And then we'll give you a grade for it. Might be a quiz, might not. We'll see. But for the ones we're taking as quizzes, if you don't do them, this is what you get for your percentage. Yeah, and you don't want to get an F for that, especially if you haven't done like 4 of them and you get 4 Fs, that's going to pull your grade down. And you don't want to do that. So make sure that you're going into the Google Classroom and you're completing every single assignment we tell you guys to do. If we tell you to do it in the video, you should be doing it. If it's written in the Royal Notes, you should be doing it. All right, make sure you're doing it. All right, we had a bunch of people miss number 10. It's the algebraic addition again. Now, all I did was change one of these numbers here, but this minus 2 at the beginning is totally fine. It's just a negative 2. So this guy gets to come straight down. He stays the same. He does not change. Now, because we have an actual minus sign in the problem, this minus a positive 5, we got to take that minus sign, we got to make it a positive sign. So we're going to go plus. See, we just made it a plus sign as we brought it down. Now, let's see who could help me. Kimber, can you help me with this one? If I change the minus sign to a plus sign, how does that change this positive 5 right here? Is it going to stay a positive 5? Or is it going to become a negative 5? What do you think? There we go. It's going to become a negative 5. Now, these are both negative numbers, negative 2 plus negative 5. So let's just get more and more negative up in here. All right, so what's 2 plus 5, Kimber? Yep. Negative 7, absolutely. I think several of you made the plus sign, but you kept that a positive number. So then you ended up with like negative, in this case, it would have been a positive 3. But yeah, the one on the test, we did not get the correct answer. So remember, if you see this negative sign, this minus sign out here in the front, in front of the positive or negative number here, you always have to change the number right behind it. Now, if I had a minus out front, like minus a negative 2, then yes, this 2 would become just a positive 2 to start off that problem. But we don't have it out there. So that thing stays negative. So it just comes straight down the way we had it. All right, I hope we're getting it. Maybe not, maybe a little, who knows. All right, check out number 14. I think every single person multiplied that correctly. Because when we multiply, it's not that hard. You just multiply. Now, in this case, because I changed the number a little bit, we're going to have 39. 3 times 3 is 9. 3 times 1 is 3. Now, a good handful of y'all, like 5 or 6 of you guys, put your decimal, boom, right there in the middle. No, it's not an addition problem. Remember, with multiplication, you gotta multiply and count. Multiply, count. I know we did a whole lesson on it, and I did a reteaching master on it where we did this stuff right here. So, multiply, then count. So let's count these decimal spaces. We got one, we got two, so we got two spaces. Drop it right there in the front, done. Would have been a correct answer. All right, check out 15. We got 0.13 times 5.5. Now, we're gonna do the same thing. 5 times 3, 15, carry the 1. 5 times 1 is 5, plus 1 is 6. Wonderful. Now, we're not done. Because this is how I give you the answers too. Because I'll have 6.5, I'll have 0.65, and I'll have 0.065. So, even though you did the math right, if you don't count your decimals right, you're going to get it wrong. So let's check this out. We got 2 spaces here. We got 1 space there, so we got 3 spaces we need to add in our answer. So let's check it. 1, 2, 3. Dropping it right there. We gotta add a 0. Boom, there's our answer. 0.065 or 65 thousandths. All right, that got you guys. That got some of y'all. It's funny, because some of you guys got this one right, where you put the decimal in the right spot, then you put the decimal in the wrong spot over here. What happened? All right, check out number 16. 16 was tricky because with this 6 right here, remember, let's see, who could I jump to? Josiah, help me out with this 6 right here. I got to do something with it before I can subtract that 1 and 1 fifth from it, right? What do I need to do to it first? Absolutely, we need to borrow. So it's going to become 5 and 5 fifths. Now we just subtract. What's 5 minus 1, Josiah? Yep, that's 4. And then 5 fifths minus 1 fifth is going to be? Absolutely, 4 fifths. Now we got to add that to 3 and 1 fifth. Now let's add our big numbers. 3 plus 4? Uh-huh. There's a nice 7. And then we got 1 fifth plus 4 fifths. What's that equal, bruh? Absolutely, 5 fifths. Now, I can't leave that 7 to 5 fifths because that's an improper fraction. So we're going to make it a nice, beautiful 8. Voila. All right, 17, 19, dealing with whole numbers. Now, when we're dealing with whole numbers in a multiplication and division problem, hey, let's go ahead and just put a 1 underneath them right to start with, just so we don't mess up. Cool, now we got fractions everywhere. Now we know what to do. Now, multiplying a fraction is just easy peasy, straight across the top, straight across the bottom, right? Let's jump to Serena. Serena, help me out here. What's 3 times 2? Yeah, there's 6. And what's 1 times 3? Absolutely, there's 3. Now we're going to multiply by this 3 and the 4 out front. Now, 3 times 6, how much, Serena? Yep, 18. And then what's 4 times 3? Absolutely. Now, 12 goes into 18 how many times? Yep, 1. And then that leaves us 6 left over. And so we're gonna have 6 over 12 is our remainder, but I can reduce that, can I, Serena? What can I reduce that down to? Absolutely, we can reduce it down to 1.5. Now, if you put the 1 on top, gonna get the answer wrong. I think that's one of the answers I gave you, is if you do it wrong, I give you that answer. So you gotta make sure you're working the problems out correctly. And show your work, show your work. I know you can't show your work on the computer screen, but do your work on a piece of paper. Because you shouldn't make these simple mistakes, you know, simple stuff when you're showing your work, when you're actually working it out, checking those answers. Now, here we got a division problem with some fractions. Now, I made this 3, whole 3, into 3 over 1. Let's rock and roll and see what happens. Now, remember, when we're dividing a fraction, our first fraction just comes straight down. Now, as we come down, we change it to multiplication because we're gonna use that reciprocal. Remember, the opposite of this 3 over 1, it's gonna become 1 over 3, and then we just multiply. 8 times 1 is 8, 9 times 3 is 27. And there's no way to reduce that. No number goes into 8, goes into 27. That's going to make it smaller. All right. So hopefully on this Friday's test, we should be a little bit more ready for it, at least with how to work out some of these problems. If you don't watch the video, it's not going to go well for you. Sorry to say. So, you know, take the time. Watch the videos. I know, you know, you gotta stare at my mug with my crazy hair up in here, but it really is worth it. So please, 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 pretty, pretty, please, check this thing out. Make sure you are looking at everything, understanding what you did wrong. Hey, if you got 100, you got 95, you got a 90, probably one or two of these problems might have been the ones you missed. Maybe even it was one of the other problems that was kind of simple and, you know, we just had simple mistakes made. But keep focusing on what you're reading, what the question's asking for. And remember, if it's addition, cool, drop that decimal straight down. If it's multiplication, you got to multiply, count how many decimal spaces over the decimals are, and add that into your answer. I know you guys can do it. Y'all smart. I know you are. All right. Cool. Maybe it's time. Yeah. Focus. Focus. You can do it. Focus. Put the video games down. I know you can do it. All right. So, we'll have a test on Friday. Good luck. All right. See you in a little bit.